Hey folks, this is Tina Hui with Follow the Coin. Just popping in with a little bit of bit news. Rumors are really hot right now surrounding Apple and the Bitcoin space. Word on the street about Apple is that they are diving into the mobile payment space as a possibility. So it seems that Apple may have had to make a patent available to the public. And said patent application reveals the back-end architecture for a versatile Omni wallet, suggesting that Apple might be entering the mobile payment space soon. And one thing that also hasn't gone unnoticed, the patent also mentions virtual currencies. Well, specifically, it was virtualized currencies. Whatever that means, just imagine if Apple enters the Bitcoin or digital currency space. What if they made their own coin? What if they made their own currency? Anyone in the tech space knows that while Google is open and pretty friendly for app developers to go on their Android platform and create and tinker with different projects, Apple is definitely more strict in the way that it enforces policies in the iOS ecosystem. Just think about it. Earlier this year, they straight up said no to all cryptocurrency-related applications in the iOS store for an indefinite amount of time. And if you're trying to operate on Apple and reach 800 million users, and if you're trying to develop an app in the iOS ecosystem, you better be very, very careful. Everybody knows from tech and Bitcoin that they're extremely strict and vet literally every single one of those applications. A recent change happened in June in which they revised their terms and conditions, and boy, was it a surprise when Apple decided to make a change to its App Store review guidelines and include Bitcoin apps back into the App Store. I can guarantee people were like, yes! So back to that patent application. The patent application itself is pretty interesting. It entails a comprehensive debit system that can handle digital debit and credit cards, as well as coupons issued by other merchants and organizations. The virtualized currency reference could actually just end up being an extremely broad blanket, which covers things like loyalty programs. But who's to say? We don't know for sure. What if Apple does go, hey, we should really create our own coin? Or, hey, we should really be doing more with Bitcoin, especially since the U.S. Patent and Trademark Organization, USPTO, published an Apple patent application for iMoney last year. If you ask us, it's all a possibility. Amazon launched Amazon Coins, so who's to say Apple won't have Apple Coins? Let's stop a second and think about all of the ways that Apple can enter the consumer market with Bitcoin and take over if they wanted to. There's Touch ID, the sensor fingerprint identification and KYC process, which they've actually opened up for third-party applications to take advantage of authenticating users with just a fingerprint in iOS 8, which is launching soon. It's also rumored that they're going to possibly launch near-field communications in the next few weeks. Then there's iBeacon technology, and they have an endless array of different brick-and-mortar applications that could just mean that they could enter the market and drive the competition away. But let's hope they play nice. In either case, if Apple were to create their own coin or dive into digital currencies more and possibly even create a wallet, it would be epic. All right, that's it for this BITBITE. Bye, guys. Thank you.